Welcome to Long Beach, California. Coverage of the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Today, round six of the 2015 season, the Grand Prix of Long Beach. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rick Benjamin. Sean Cermony alongside Todd Lewis has our coverage today down on Pit Road. The second consecutive weekend for the Stadium Super Trucks on asphalt here at Long Beach, California. Sean, it's an awesome place to come and race, and this is kind of the birthplace of off-road racing.
Oh, it is. Being here in Southern California, not just that, but then being in Long Beach, it's such a prestigious event. And now here we are, the home of off-road racing. You know, Baja right down the road, all the close course racing here. It's an absolute honor to be back here with this brand new series. And now, 3 years in a row, here we are in Long Beach. Very exciting weekend.
I know the fans love it out here.
They do. You know, it's actually one of the classes where it's so exciting that if you haven't seen it, it takes at least 3-4 laps for you to even understand what's happening out in front of you. It's so wild. They're swapping paint, high-flying action, and they're right up to the fences. You know, they're 4 or 5 people deep all the way around, and it's the one race where even the IndyCar people come out of the paddock to come watch some of this high-flying action, so it's great.
The stands are filling up here on the streets of Long Beach for round six of the Stadium Super Trucks, part of the Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. These guys have been getting at it all weekend, Sean. This is Saturday practice.
So a few new guys at the pack here, Rick, which is very interesting. We had Kyle LeDuc have a little bit of trouble, a couple other drivers as well. But, of course, there is Gavin Harlan, number 55. Very exciting weekend for him.
Bill Hines with a big problem here.
Well, we were playing with the setup a little bit, so had a different setup than St. Pete where the truck was flying really well. And, you know, I came off a ramp, and then my back end got into the tires, and then it just whipped me around. So it's kind of like, you know, holding on for dear life, and then I hit the concrete wall. And, I knew it was hurt pretty bad, and, you know, I was shooken up a little bit, but, you know, I went in the hauler, took some Advil, and, you know, feeling pretty good now, so...
New face Kyle LeDuc had problems as well.
Just got up one of those super kickers on the straightaway, and I think we may have an issue with some of the suspension, but I feel like I didn't screw up, and the truck threw me pretty crooked, and I just did a quick little save, and it was able to, you know, wasn't able to catch it, and it spun me down the straightaway.
So they'll fix both of those trucks, the Hines truck and the LeDuc truck, and get them ready. Now this morning, practice and a qualifying session.
And these guys really picking up the pace now. They know their qualifying time counts. They need the fastest lap they possibly can. Robbie Gordon's not going to use this lap. As you see, him brings it around on the front stretch. But he does keep it out of the wall, as you see the kids and everyone right up against the fences, Rick.
It is a spectacular show. The Stadium Super Trucks in action. Sheldon Creed, our fast qualifier, our 145.85 two-second lap here on the streets of Long Beach. 5 rounds of a 20-round season complete. Creed, Robbie Gordon, Kincaid, Vizo, and Matt Mingay, who will run the rest of the series. Those are your top 5 in championship points. A lot at stake here as we get set to go racing on the streets of Long Beach. More to come with the Stadium Super Trucks.
The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires. We are Toyo, driven to perform.
The cold truth is, you can't work from home when you're sick. You need real relief. Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Cold and Flu has 3 cold symptom fighters to relieve your tough symptoms. Stay unstoppable. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
The bigger, more advanced, and more capable Fiat 500X crossover with available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded has never looked so sharp. Lease a 500X for only $179 a month for 39 months and get up to 34 mpg highway.
Fight your enemies, conquer their cities, and expand your empire. Play now at tw2.tv.
Avocados from Mexico.
It's a full collection of expert quarterback analysis every week on NFL Monday QB, delivered by FedEx tomorrow at 6 on CBS Sports Network.
The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks, presented by Traxxas. Round number 6 about to unfold on the streets of Long Beach, California, the legendary Long Beach Grand Prix Circuit. Great crowd on hand. Sean Sermony, we're getting set to see these trucks haul it down into turn one here. I can't wait to see the action at this track. Practice and qualifying, full of action. Speaking of full of action, round one of the season conducted at the Adelaide Parkland Circuit in Adelaide, Australia. The Stadium Super Trucks, a three-race weekend, part of the Clipsal 500 V8 Supercar event down there. Sean, you were there. This was a terrific show.
It absolutely was. You know, what an honor it was to be part of the V8 Supercar Series down here at the Clipsal Race. And these fans, you know, they had a special treat all weekend long. And a lot of action. You see a little highlight there. Lawrence getting into the wall. A lot of great stuff going on. And some of the Australians really adapt to these trucks quickly.
Charles Dorrance of Austin, Texas, though, on the pace lap, didn't adapt very well to the new circuit. Had a problem going around the right-hander, upside down and into the barrier. But he's okay. The truck will survive as well. Now, the start of race one.
See, right off the bat, race one, Nathan Prix is out in front. One of the Australians comes out of the U-classes, gets right into the SSTs, starts leading the pack right off the bat.
Bill Hines, an early second-place runner. We take an onboard ride with E.J. Vizo in the 5 truck, the former IndyCar star. Vizo was a standout all weekend.
He certainly was. You know, Vizo's got quite a bit of time in these trucks. You know, he knows how to run the handbrake. He knows how to shift just properly. You see him right there making that pass to the lead, going by the Toyo Tires truck of Nathan Pretty. And next thing you know, he's just out front looking really comfortable.
Nathan Pretty, meantime, on the second lap, had a problem, a broken left front suspension piece. Not very pretty there as he fights to keep control of the 56.
Well, you see, Nathan did get into the wall, which was really upsetting for him. He said, I talked to him, I said, what happened? He said, I got out of the U-truck, got into this one, the pedals went right, put it into the wall.
Brad Gallard there in the 454 would have his challenges ahead as well. We ride with Sheldon Creed here in the 74.
You see, Creed here gets into Gallard in that Peter Kittle truck, takes that red Traxxas truck around in front of him, but he had to run the rest of his race with his hood in his face.
Tough way to go, no question. E.J. Vizo scores the victory, the season opener, round number one, down in Adelaide, Australia. The Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas, first race of the season. Vizo defeats Robbie Gordon. Matt Midgay from Australia and Keegan Kincaid, one of our hot young guns from the U.S., ends up fourth in the 47 truck. First of three races down in Adelaide, Australia. They're lined up now. Race number two came on Saturday of that weekend. We've got a great field of trucks lined up as well. Now, again, with qualifying, the inversion takes place. Fast qualifier starts at the back but earns bonus points.
Absolutely. That's the way it is. You actually get a point off for just the weekend points, not the yearly points. So it's motocross style. Whoever has the least amount of points at the end of the weekend is the weekend's winner. So if you qualify fastest, you got to start in the back of the pack, but you're already kind of starting ahead. Right now, who isn't starting ahead? You see the 454 of Gallard gets pummeled in by the 57 of Bill Hines into the kitty litter. Not a good start of that race for them guys.
Not at all. Nathan Pretty, though, was on the button early. Had his problems in the first event. They repaired the truck, got him back out. Robbie Gordon artfully flying over the jumps here. Lap number three, we've got a battle up front. Pretty trying to hang on. And the Matt Midgay truck, the Hot Wheels truck, getting into the back end of Keegan Kincaid's machine.
Well, I'll tell you, maybe not the most gentlemanly-like way to get around that turn to Kincaid. And you see Vizo into the wall. Vizo struggled all throughout race number two.
Hard to believe because he won the open.
It was. You know, usually he's so calm and mellow. But he came out in race two, and Vizo really had a hard time. You know, and maybe it was Matt Midgay here saying, hey, brand new in the truck, and Matt was so fast that maybe that got in Vizo's head a little bit when he's trying to get around him.
Sheldon Creed there, Robbie Gordon. Here's Vizo again. Same spot on the racetrack.
And same guy again, Matt Midgay. So once again, you know, maybe the new Aussie coming out here is messing with Vizo's head a little bit, but he wasn't able to put a good race together in race two.
Final lap on Saturday, race number two. Creed and Robbie Gordon to the stripe, to the checkered flag for the win. Creed beats Gordon by a truck length. Great battle between those two.
Absolutely, it was. You know, and that's something I think we're going to see all year long. But so far for our Adelaide races, you see a lot of Creed and you see a lot of Gordon and you see a lot of paint swapping between the two of them.
Checkered flag falls over Sheldon Creed, his first win of the season. Robbie Gordon comes home second. Matt Mingay from Australia and EJ Bizzo, despite the problems, rounding out the top four. Then it was time for round three at Adelaide on Sunday.
And right now, Mingay so far with 2/3, and both Friday and Saturday, which was kind of a big surprise. First weekend out in the truck, running it hard. Now out in front, you see Charles Dorrance. He had trouble earlier on Friday. Now he's in the lead, looking comfortable. Who's right behind him is Gallard as well. Both those guys not qualifying quite the way they wanted to from their lap times yesterday, but you see him moving out front early on, get a little bit of lead over the pack.
Gallard moving to the inside of Charles Dorrance to take the lead on the first lap in Sunday's event. Some three-wide racing here, and some guys having trouble.
Then you see the 56 of Pretty getting around. Pretty setting good lap times all weekend, but having a lot of bad luck. And then, as we've seen all weekend long, here is Vizo and Mingay getting into each other. Vizo kind of pushing him off from the wall. Then the 454 of Brad Gallard. Full lawn dart off into the grass, Rick.
Spent a fair amount of time in the weeds, and here is that shot from on board the 454. Gallard able to stop it short of the concrete, though. Later on, lap four, coming to halfway, you've got the 74 of Sheldon Creed, the 7 of Robbie Gordon fighting it out for a second behind Keegan Kincaid, who's got some damage, but a nice lead.
Keegan looking really comfortable all weekend long. He's been very smart about it, and now he's got a little damage, but he's real mellow. He's looking to rearview mirror, saw that battle unfold, and he was able to pull a good lead.
EJ Bizzo with another spin there. EJ having some difficulty coming to terms with this racetrack. Meantime, final corner, last lap, Robbie Gordon tries the dive bomb, leans on his fellow competitor, the 74. Keegan Kincaid and the 47 will come home the winner. Gordon is second. Sheldon Creed loses it at the line.
And Sheldon upside down into the wall. He has always been the showstopper. Without a doubt, down in Adelaide, Australia, they absolutely ate that young man up. He loved his style.
No question about it. Sheldon Creed, a fan favorite in the Clipsal 500 weekend, the season opening weekend for the Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Here's an onboard look at what Sheldon did. Calm as you could possibly be going upside down in this thing.
You're looking really comfortable there. You didn't even see his eyes get wide as he gets to the wall, hang loose to all of his competitors and the fans.
One more look at it. Fans on their feet applauding the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck presented by Traxxas. Stars, a great event.
Over 280,000 people all weekend long here in Adelaide, and these guys had an opportunity to really show off, and it was very, very exciting.
Australia, of course, a hotbed of motorsports with the V8 Supercars and other series. The Stadium Super Trucks will return when we return. Kincaid the winner, by the way. More from Long Beach.
I'm a sore loser. I'm a sore loser.
Losing is not an option for me.
Be the best.
The best.
The best.
You have to have the best equipment under the hood.
That's why I
only use
Kometic products in my engines.
Kometic gasket. Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket. Kometic gasket, a superior quality gasket for those of us who demand the highest level of performance.
Seen the Showtime Emmy Award-winning drama Homeland.
Hardcore jihadis right here in Germany.
Now's the time to see what everyone's talking about.
You're CIA.
I was in the CIA. I'm a private citizen now.
Your name is on a kill list.
Someone is trying to kill me, and I'm just supposed to accept that? Spend my life on the run? Give up my daughter? I'm staying.
Homeland. Experience the phenomenon only on Showtime. Start your free trial now.
More than 2 million men and women have served in our military since 9/11. Now, many of them are transitioning back into civilian life. They're considering career options, writing resumes, starting businesses. ACP AdvisorNet can help. ACP AdvisorNet is a nonprofit online community where Americans can offer career advice to those who have served. Now we can serve those who served us by helping them to find their next career. Visit acpadvisornet.org.
Motorsports, endless possibilities between the start and finish line. Two wheels, four wheels, short track, long track, no track. Cars, bikes, carts, trucks. If they ride it, we got it. Off-road, on-road, rocky road. Little jumps, big jumps, bigger jumps. America, Europe, Asia, Australia. We don't discriminate, we just accelerate. Start your engines. Wednesday night, starting at 7, only on CBS Sports Network.
Maybe he's really focused.
Hey, Michael. Maybe he likes spinning the wheels.
Maybe he just loves trucks.
Maybe he's just being a boy.
Preoccupation with objects is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better.
Welcome back. We're on the streets of Long Beach for the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Part of the Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. I'm Rick Benjamin, Sean Sermony alongside Todd Lewis with our coverage on Pit Road. This will be round six of the 2015 season as we continue to get you caught up on how we got to this point in the year. Trucks getting ready to come out on the racetrack at Long Beach. But let's go back to round number four, Sean. This was at St. Petersburg back in the month of March.
You see them starting off on the airport runway here as they get into the street circuit in just a moment as they file in the turn one. This is a long, fast straightaway, so you see them. The trick is, get through turn one clean so I can be part of the rest of the race. And you see him here doing that right now as Eric Davis in the Replay XD, always involved. The truck is out front. And Rick, we hop on board with the five of EJ Bezo.
Now, Bezo had kind of a challenging weekend, but he's always fast. Of course, he won one of the rounds in Australia. Here he's trying to make a move on the 48 of Scotty Steele.
You see him here going too wide right now. EJ Bezo and Keegan Kincaid off that jump. 140 miles an hour on that straightaway. But our early leader, Rick, Eric Davis, gets spun around, collects Scotty Steele. That gives EJ Bezo the opportunity to go from all the way to the back of the pack right to the lead.
Absolutely. Keegan Kincaid, Sheldon Creed in the mix. You're on board with Creed. Kincaid, one of his buddies, as they go side by side behind Bezo.
He's able to make that pass stick. Now keep it in mind, Sheldon Creed starting all the way in the rear as our fast qualifier moves up through the pack pretty quickly. Knew he needed to catch EJ Bezo, who kind of made it the easy way around with that accident earlier on in the race. Drove around the outside of everyone, but now they unleash the beast on each other, Rick.
Bezo, Creed right behind him, final lap here. These two will not have an easy time of it getting to the checkered flag. Watch the action here. Bezo goes sideways. Creed gets by him. Bezo buys the wall.
And Bezo gives up two extra spots on there, Rick. He goes from the lead, dropping all the way back in the pack.
Here's another look at it. He had trouble on the right-hand side first, it turns out, before he got to the corner.
Now you see him. He goes in a little too hot, tries to line it up, but there's Sheldon Creed. It just won't go away. Bezo gets over to the other side of the track, and now he's swap paint with both sides of his car, and he's dropped all the way back to fourth.
There is no margin for error on these street courses such as we have here on the streets of St. Petersburg. Checkered flag waving on round number four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck season. Creed, your winner by a half a second over Keegan Kincaid. Gordon, EJ Bezo, and how about Burt Jenner looking pretty quick this weekend?
Well, it's the thing, you know, Burt's always had the speed. He's had the ability. He's just got to hold it together to the last lap, and maybe we'll see that from him here in the future.
It does turn out to be a good weekend for Burt. We'll show you more of what happened in St. Petersburg after four rounds. The championship, a tie. Creed and last year's champion, Robbie Gordon.
Now, that makes a great battle, the two of those right there. But Creed, the young man, already tied up front. He was finished second last year overall. He's got a great opportunity to win this thing when it's over and done with.
All right, on Sunday, round five of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Right back here on the streets of St. Petersburg, Scotty Steele in that red 48 would take the early lead.
Starting grid lined up from the fastest lap time from Saturday for each truck. Well, you see out front, Steele, he got collected up early on in the Davis accident. He is one of the faster drivers on this series. Now he's sitting right out front. Great opportunity for him to run hard.
EJ Bezo had problems on Saturday. We go on board with him briefly. Lalo Laguna there in the 17 as he sits in the fourth, fifth position. Sheldon Creed looking back at him. They had a good battle early.
They did have a great battle. You see him almost side by side there, up to 140 miles an hour. Then you see Lalo Laguna and Keegan Kincaid in the 47 having quite a battle here as well. Meanwhile, Burt Jenner putting a lot of pressure on EJ Bezo, diving to the inside on him with his sights set on an early leader, Scotty Steele.
Steele up front, meantime, Jenner right behind, and there's Bezo, well within striking distance, but Scotty Steele, who started up front, would have a problem on this lap.
You know, it's been a long weekend for Scotty. He had a problem earlier on, getting an accident yesterday before lap one was even completed. And then you see him here on the Sunday race coasting in. Looks like he spun an axle in that truck.
Under power, but not enough power. Lalo Laguna with a huge spin later in the day. That brings out a caution here coming off the final corner.
You see Lalo trying to collect himself here as he gets to going down that front stretch. Not a lot of street experience from Lalo Laguna, so he did a lot of learning here at St. Petersburg.
Burt Jenner was the restart leader. We take the competition yellow halfway through. Sheldon Creed on board here. Bezo trying to drive to the inside, going into the left-hand corner.
Driving to the inside of Sheldon Creed. These two battling back and forth all weekend long.
Creed and Bezo. A lot of contact here. Vizo's camera looking back at Creed, not afraid to lay the bumper to Bezo.
I see Rick. He's on the inside here. Meanwhile, Burt Jenner's watching this great battle unleashed behind him in the rearview mirror. A lot of pressure on Burt.
Burt Jenner trying for his first career win on Sunday at St. Petersburg. Creed and Bezo using up those front and rear bumpers on the Stadium Super Truck.
Now I tell you, you see these guys, they get along great in the pits, and they don't feel like they push each other too much as you see them really leaning on one another here, but that's the way these two guys like to drive.
Eight tires sometimes work better than four in a place like this, and that's what you've got with Bezo and Creed leaning on each other. Damage, and Creed goes around, Bezo goes up and over.
And then you see them get hooked together. It's a sad finish for those two drivers, both of them fighting for a possible victory.
Tough break. A couple of the major contenders on the day, seeing their chances go away. All of this benefiting Burt Jenner, who scores his first career victory in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. What a happy winner.
See Burt inside there. He's had opportunities to win before. He's been in the lead, but had made some mistakes. Now he's up on top of the podium. You know that feels good for Burt.
Keegan Kincaid almost 6 seconds back in second. Robbie Gordon third. Then Creed and Bezo, the rest of the top five. Lalo Laguna, despite the spin, comes home sixth. Post-race, Todd Lewis spoke to our very happy winner.
It feels amazing. You know, all these guys, they've been doing it a long time. They've been putting in a lot of races, a lot of different series and stuff. You know, I'm the rookie here. So, I'm 36 years old, but it doesn't mean I haven't wanted to be a race car driver my whole life. And, you know, sometimes that self-doubt, you wonder if you got what they got and what it takes to get on top of the box. And this proves it.
All right, let's take a look at the championship standings after five rounds out of 20 that this season we'll see. Creed goes on top by 3 points over Robbie Gordon. Kincaid right there with 121 markers. Then Bezo and Matt Mingay, the Australian, who will not run the U.S. portion of the series. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks getting set to get at it on the streets of Long Beach. We'll come right back with our starting lineup for today's event.
I'm a sore loser.
I'm a sore loser.
Losing is not an option for me.
Be the best.
The best.
The best.
You have to have the best equipment under the hood.
That's why I
only use
Kometic products in my engines.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket, a superior quality gasket
for those of us who demand the highest level of performance.
This is it. Game day, best day of the week. And when you play 1 week fantasy football on DraftKings, every week is another shot at victory. Every week, use your knowledge and showcase your skills. So what are you waiting for? You like football? You like winning? How about you like them both at the same time and make this week the week you get it done? This is DraftKings. Welcome to the big time.
Play 1 week fantasy football at DraftKings.com this Sunday. Play free with promo code BYWEEK.
I know a lot of complicated routines, but when it comes to keeping my skin clear, I like to keep it real simple.
So ditch breakouts the easy way with X-Out.
X-Out did all of this. It's working so good.
X-Out's the first and only one-step wash-in acne treatment.
It's like, bam.
Wow.
And the Icy Cool Blast tells you it's working and feels amazing.
Like a breath mint for your face.
You'll even get our amazing body bar free. So go online and order now.
X-Out pimples, fast and simple.
Visit a Kawasaki dealer to experience ErgoFit adjustability and find your fit on the new Vulcan S.
It's the personification of pride and passion.
It's such an exciting time of the year. If you're not all in, if you just want to put your toes in the water, you've got no chance.
We're bringing you more of the game you love with Inside College Football.
If they don't get it done this year, you won't be in big trouble.
Tuesday at 9, only on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome back to Long Beach, California, coverage of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. I'm Rick Benjamin. Sean Sermony is alongside Todd Lewis with our coverage in the pit area today. Time for our starting lineup for the season's sixth round. Bill Hines out of Nazareth, Pennsylvania. He'll be on the pole in that 57 truck. Starting second from Mesa, Arizona, young Gavin Harlan.
Also Gavin, a 2014 X Games competitor.
Wow. Young gun as well. Starting third, Charles Dorrance out of Austin, Texas. And next in line in the fourth starting spot today, how about Kyle LeDuc from Beaumont, California? The LeDuc's a very well-known off-road family.
Absolutely. And LeDuc, this is his first time out on a big street circuit. A little bit of trouble in practice, but he's really picked up the pace.
Dale Dindell in the 17 will line up fifth, first time with us this year. And there's the veteran, E.J. Viso, in the 5 truck from Caracas, Venezuela. Going seventh today, Eric Davis from Los Angeles. That is the 75 truck, the always evolving machine. And then the 8th starter, guy who's up front every week, Keegan Kincaid.
Keegan Kincaid. You can never count him out. He's nice and mellow and very, very fast. I'm sure you're going to see him near the front of the pack.
Arizona Scotty Steele will line up ninth in the 48. Had problems in Florida. Robbie Gordon from Orange, California in the truck number 7. Will start 10th today. And our final two starters starting 11th. St. Pete Sunday winner Burt Jenner from Los Angeles in the 50. And our final starter, fast qualifier, Sheldon Creed from Alpine, California. Always fast in that 74.
He is always fast. But what I think is great, Burt Jenner comes off a win. Now he's the second fastest qualifier. One of the top dogs.
Our track here, just a shade under 2 miles, 11 turns. And Sean, you've watched as the Stadium Super Truck crew has placed 4 difficult jumps around here.
They certainly have. Coming out of 6 and 7, going 8. That's a downhill jump. Very high speed right there. Downhill jump. Now they really open it up as they got to back it down, going into 9. This jump, they're going to hit on an angle, going into 10, landing sideways. And then open it up all the way coming out of 11 down that front stretch over those two main jumps.
And back to start finish. That is Shoreline Drive here in Long Beach. That kink in it makes it, it is a straightaway. You're flat out, but it makes it very, very challenging. There you see the Traxxas and the Toyo jumps back at the head of the front straightaway. Trucks are on the racetrack. Drivers are buckled in, ready to drop the green. Standing start. There's Gavin Harlan, the youngster, in that 55 truck. Now, he has been running with the series, but hasn't made his first appearance until today here in 2015. Here we go on the streets of Long Beach.
And they are off right now. Bill Hines out in front at that live truck. Live, the multi-platinum recording artist, sponsoring 3 trucks in the field. Bill Hines is one of those 3, and he is out to an early lead.
Hines over Harlan as they haul it down Shoreline. Now, the first turn here is a hard left, a 90-degree left. You've got to whoa these trucks out from, what, 140 or so miles an hour?
About 140 miles an hour, Rick, on this long straight going in here. Now, it's a pretty tight turn. First lap, not so bad. The brakes are going to start fading away on these trucks as we get later on in the race. You'll see these drivers, we go to any in cabs, they'll be pumping the brake going into that turn, but they're still going to be flat on the skinny pedal.
They've been racing here on this circuit for more than 40 seasons. What an epic event on the West Coast. Huge opportunity for the Stadium Super Trucks to thrill the fans and put on a great show here on Sunday of Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. Hines and Harlan side by side, and Harlan gets by to take the lead.
Harlan takes it around the outside. Can he make it sick? He does. Hines was smart about it. He backed off a little bit there, said, hey, too early to race. Let's not get in a crash. You see Harlan right now already moving out.
This is out of the turn 6-7 complex. This is what we're talking about, a downhill jump.
And it's a fast downhill, and they're going into that jump in a torque wheelie. You see the front tire up in the air, and then they're hitting that ramp like that. It's a wild section.
This is the backstretch at the Long Beach Grand Prix circuit. This is where you really gain some speed as well.
Two sections on this track, the front and the back, where these trucks are 140, just pinned out. You see them dive into nine here, but then they got a ramp. They're hitting sideways. Look at Devin Harlan jumping sideways into that turn. It's really the only fast way around this section.
Harlan has taken the lead. Kyle LeDuc has moved up a couple of spots as well. Here's Vizo on the inside of that white truck, trying to elbow his way by Bert Jenner.
It almost looked like Vizo got on the brakes a little sooner than expected there. And there you go. Jenner got right into him as we're on board here with Sheldon Creed. Really cool shot.
Those first two jumps coming off the final turn. Our Replay XD onboard cameras working to perfection today. Harlan, LeDuc, Vizo, Hines, and Jenner, your top five as we open up lap number two.
Right now, making it look easy. Harlan out in front, feeling very comfortable. But meanwhile, you see him all packed up back here as Phil Hines gets a little sideways, almost gets in the tires.
You've got to make that hard left turn on trucks that are not built to do that at the highest speed portion of this racetrack on the streets of Long Beach. Here's another look from one of the onboard views of what happened in the final corner.
There's going in the last turn right there. Looked like Diesel got on the brakes a little sooner than expected. Bert Jenner piled right into him. As I've said in past broadcasts, no love lost in between Vizo and Jenner as the two of them swap paint early on in the race.
Kincaid, Robbie Gordon, Scotty Steele all trying to work their way up from the back of the pack among the quicker qualifiers here this weekend. Dale Dondell there in the 17 giving way as they go three wide to the jump.
Now, Dondell, this is something new for him. He is a desert champion. I mean, Dondell is a bad, bad man out in the desert in the trophy truck. But to be here on the asphalt, on the street circuit, something brand new to him. But if you look at his lap times for practice and qualifying, he's a contender. He can run in the pack.
Awesome to see him out here doing battle in the stadium super trucks on the pavement, on the road course in Long Beach with the jumps mixed in as well. Running order top of your screen, as always, as we bring you coverage of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas, round number six of the season. We'll come right back to the streets of Long Beach.
Not getting enough oomph out of your energy drink? Then try an extra strength 5-hour energy shot. Its beefed up blend of vitamins, nutrients, and caffeine make it the very definition of extra strength. Plus, every great flavor has zero sugar and 4 calories. So, for an energy shot that really pulls its own weight, switch to extra strength 5-hour energy. Oh, could you go left up here? I need to pick up my dry cleaning.
I hold it down like a Snapchat. Go over your head like a snapback. Uploaded a pic, double tap that. And your flow so old, granddad.
Bruh.
It's just banter.
Yeah.
I'm way too much like a black cab.
I boss.
What you Snapchatting in the club for? Just dance, man. Like, yo, fam, a lamb. Yo, fam, yo, fam, a lamb. And yo, girl, better than.
Nah.
I ain't got time to be TikTok.
Nah.
But I got a new wristwatch.
Dang, 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 dang. Bang, dang.
Technicians needed. If you're good with your hands and looking for a great career, get started here. Universal Technical Institute, UTI, gives you real-world hands-on training.
It was just a dream for me.
Within 18 months, it was a reality.
It gave me a foot in the door that most people don't have.
UTI partners with the world's top manufacturers who need our professionally trained techs working in their shops.
It's the next level of technician.
They are the best of the best.
Your new career starts your first day at UTI. Call now.
Back in Long Beach, California, the streets of Long Beach, the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Alongside Sean Sermony, I'm Rick Benjamin. Todd Lewis has our coverage on pit road. On the gas hard, working lap number three here today, as Burt Jenner, with some damage to that truck, trying to work his way closer to the front. Kevin Harlan still with a substantial lead.
Right now we're on board with Sheldon Prix. You see him, as you mentioned before, 140 miles an hour. That's the easy part. It's the braking, especially as the race goes on, the fluid gets hot. These guys are going to start pumping the brakes going in these turns. You see Robbie Gordon dives to the inside.
Keegan Kincaid, the veteran, young veteran, spins there but catches it.
Not something you see a lot out of Keegan Kincaid. I think Robbie, put a little pressure on him there, made him run it in a little bit farther than he wanted to. But Kincaid usually really keeps it under wraps. And you see a great battle right now in between LeDuc, Bizzo, and Creed. They are battling for the second position, Rick.
Coming down the back straightaway. Remember, LeDuc had a problem in practice on Saturday. Got behind a little on his steering, got into the wall. Goes sideways here as Creed dives inside.
Dives to the inside of LeDuc, but three-wheeling going at that Toyo Tires ramp, Rick, and then fast down that hill. What an exciting section of the track that is.
One of the most compelling and challenging parts of this racetrack to jump as you're going downhill. Of course, turn 11, the famous hairpin, would be one of the other difficult spots for these trucks because you've really got to slow down radically to be able to make that right-hand turn onto the front stretch. Great battle here, Vizo, Creed. You've got LeDuc right behind and Burt Jenner.
Look at Jenner's hood, all push up. That was from lap one. Before they even completed the lap there, on the last and final turn of lap one, Burt got into the back of Bizzo a little bit. Now he's got to go down those long straights with his hood in his face.
Gets into LeDuc, turns LeDuc sideways a little. This is the turn 11 hairpin that's so difficult in any kind of race car. They navigate it with a little bit of body slamming going on. Harlan continuing the lead.
Now you see all the trucks getting a little sideways on this front stretch. They come out of that turn, they go over that Toyo Tires ramp. They land, they're a little out of whack, but you can't back out of the gas. You got to stay on that skinny pedal on the right as they go off the Traxxas jump. Really sends every one of these trucks for a bit of a loop. It's a wild ride in that cab.
Sheldon Creed trying to make the crossover move on E.J. Bizzo here as they come to turn one. Bizzo able to hold the advantage and drops to the inside and stay in front of Creed. Meantime, Jenner pushes it too hard and catches the wall and some banner.
I'd have to think, Rick, there's got to be a little bit of damage to that truck. He got in the wall pretty hard. That was a fast section to be coming around and touching the wall that way.
Now, replay, this kind of began before we got to this point. There's Vizo, Creed, and LeDuc here with Jenner going down into turn one.
And then LeDuc and Jenner really going at it back and forth. And you see him going into the wall. Yeah, that was a pretty tough hit there.
Winner of the round five event at St. Petersburg back in March, and Jenner's got that banner kind of wrapped around, it wrapped briefly around the rear wheel. Now, Burt, meantime, trying to shoulder his way by LeDuc.
Now, I would have to think right now that Burt Jenner's saying, we know we got a mandatory competition caution right around the corner. If I can just nurse the truck to that point, maybe pull over quick, get a course worker, anyone, to help me pull this banner out, that could affect braking or anything.
Now, he did kind of side slap the soft wall and then the concrete. These are very tough race trucks that have been put together by the Stadium Super Trucks team. Any chance there's damage on that truck?
I think that there very well could be. It's hard to say right now what's going on with the truck. He did fall off the pace a little bit right now. But like I said, maybe he's waiting for that comp caution to come right around the corner here. Well, he could kind of regroup, get that banner ripped out. Or maybe he did cause some damage. He did slap that concrete wall pretty hard.
On board with Burt Jenner, the winner at St. Petersburg in the Sunday event, it does look like he's got a problem. He's off the gas. Jenner pulling on the pit road, slowing down here. What a shame for the veteran driver, doing a great job in the early season, talking to one of the crew members. Looks like he's afraid he's got some sort of significant problem. He's pulled at the pit road, getting ready to shut it off. Meantime, the action continues as we come close to halfway in the competition yellow. Gavin Harlan there in the 55, still your leader. Vizo and Creed have caught him.
Well, I've been wondering the whole time what Vizo and Creed are thinking. Not only are they having to deal with battling each other, but they're seeing the young man Harlan out in front the whole time. First time back in Stadium Super Trucks this weekend. Here in Long Beach for Harlan, and he's been out in front of these guys the whole entire race and running extremely well.
Just gives up the lead, though, to E.J. Bizzo. Sheldon Creed knocking on the door as well. They do a little contact dance as they head to the jump coming off turn 6 and 7. Creed almost loses it there. Harlan right back trying to hold on to the lead over Vizo, but Vizo gets by.
Yeah, Harlan's a young kid. He's absolutely fearless, and I don't believe he's going to let a veteran like Vizo just walk away on him right now. He's going to work him over as best he can to get that lead back.
Harlan tries to dive to the inside. Vizo, though, starts to slide a little early, and obviously these drivers realize you've got to kick the back end out before you get to the corner. Kind of a dirt driving technique here.
Absolutely it is, and that's where Harlan comes from. You know, he is a dirt background, as is Creed. Vizo, he's the one that comes from 6 full years of racing IndyCar, testing Formula One. So the street course is kind of his thing, but this is two styles of driving mixed together as one. As you see him, 1, 2, and 3, Vizo, Harlan, and Creed going down those jumps. All those trucks a little bit banged up right now. Harlan, his truck was beautiful a lap ago.
All right, competition yellow falls as we begin lap number 6 of 10 today here on the streets of Long Beach. Sheldon Creed waving to the fans and maybe a fellow competitor as well. Now, the trucks will bunch back up for a restart next time around.
That's right, Rick. They'll go into their mandatory competition caution, which you'll see at every feature event at SST Racing, which means midway through the race, full course yellow, pack it up, go racing again.
Vizo will be our restart leader. Meantime, Burt Jenner, who won the Sunday event at St. Petersburg in March, done for the day. He's with Todd.
Burt, I can see the disappointment on your face. Give me what happened from your seat, what it looked like out there.
Hats off to LeDuc. First time in a long time he's been in the truck this weekend. But he picked up a lot of speed there at the end. I was just trying to keep up with Creed and Vizo, who are starting to kind of get away from us. And I tried for a little bit of a dive bomb, a little too aggressive. Couldn't get it stopped in time, put it in the wall. So broke a suspension part, figured pull it off before I wrecked the truck worse than it already is, and come back and get them next time.
Broken suspension parts, not something you can run these trucks with, as tough as they are. Fans loving it. The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. We're on the streets of Long Beach. Right back with the restart in just a moment.
Out for a bike ride. I didn't think I'd have a heart attack, but I did.
I'm Mike, and I'm very much alive. Now my doctor recommends a Bayer aspirin regimen to help prevent another heart attack.
Be sure to talk to your doctor before you begin an aspirin regimen.
After 10 years of providing top-notch customer service and quality products, we're still rated number one by the Wall Street Journal for do-it-yourself paint chip repairs. Our signature dab, smear, and blend process allows you to make professional, permanent repairs on your car. And now our squirt and squeegee method makes it even easier to fix the most heavily chipped vehicles. Simply squirt a little paint on the panel, squeegee it smooth over the chips, then blend as usual. Go to drcolorchip.com. That's drcolorchip.com.
Fight your enemies, conquer their cities, and expand your empire. Play now at TW2.tv. Strike back at TW2.tv.
Avocados from Mexico.
The countdown to 8 seconds is on.
Buckle up for the PBR tonight at 8 on CBS Sports Network.
Back on the streets of Long Beach, Rick Benjamin along with Sean Sermony, Todd Lewis on pit road, ready for the restart after the competition yellow. Final four laps of action as round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas unfolds today in front of a packed house of fans. Eric Davis toward the back of the field behind the three of Charles Dorrance. Bill Hines in the 57. They're going to try to move up in these last few laps, but it's Vizo who leads him over the first two jumps under the bridge into the green flag.
Well, that's the competition caution to come out of right now, which means it is a drag race to the finish line. It's a drag race to the checkered flag. We've seen young Gavin Harlan lead the majority of this race. Now he got some of these guys that have been in the trucks a little bit longer, Creed, Vizo, and they're pushing him around a little bit. Harlan's truck's a little banged up right now. It's going to be a long ride to the checkered flag.
Harlan, though, with the inside move, coming into turn one to get up alongside Vizo and retakes the lead.
You see, adding to this mess now is Robbie Gordon, that bright orange number 7 Speed Energy truck, moved up into P4. Robbie oftentimes towards the end of the race has the best seat in the house, seeing some of these young drivers just unleash everything they've got on each other, and he scoots his way up onto the podium. I think Robbie's trying to stick with that plan right now, Rick.
Vizo and Harlan side by side down the short straightaway from the top spot here as the laps start to wind down. Creed is third, Gordon is fourth. Vizo with the outside move retakes the point.
I gotta think, Rick, that Vizo and Creed are impressed, but certainly not pleasantly surprised by how fast Harlan is. He certainly has put quite a battle in here and has an opportunity to win this race yet. It's not over.
Leaders steaming down the backstretch here on the streets of Long Beach. Awesome racetrack, great facility, lots of history in the stadium. Super Trucks marking their second anniversary with this event this weekend. Scotty Steele running to the inside of LeDuc here.
Scotty Steele leaning on LeDuc a little bit there. Scotty has had several podiums in stadium Super Truck racing. LeDuc has not, but he has picked up the pace for the last 2 days of practice and qualifying, and LeDuc is really starting to move out in that 99 Toyota tire truck.
Meantime, Sheldon Creed is on the move. Up along. Oh, he loses and has to skip the ramp. What does that mean, Sean?
Well, he had to skip the ramp, so he couldn't gain any ground on anyone. So you saw him moved over, backed out of the pit gas a little bit, let Harlan get back up where he was. Otherwise, if he didn't, he would end up getting a stop and go penalty next lap around.
Robbie Gordon on the charge now on the front straightaway, watching the second and third place trucks. Vizo taking the opportunity, watching that battle in his rearview mirror to drive off to a nice advantage here.
Well, a couple great battles. Obviously, this battle for the lead is great, but look at these guys right here. This is a battle for fifth place right now. That is Steele, LeDuc, and Kincaid. Keegan Kincaid can undoubtedly be on top of the podium at any given time. And right now, he's pushing hard with three to go.
Fourth, fifth, and sixth in play here on the streets of Long Beach. Next up for the Stadium Super Trucks will be on the streets of Belle Isle, Detroit. Gavin Harlan has turned in a great run today, back in second spot. Let's get on board with Robbie Gordon in the 7 truck, the defending series champion, sitting in fourth. He can see the top three. They may be sitting ducks for Gordon.
Oh, they absolutely could. You know, he likes to pick them off one at a time. If you see the trucks up in front of them, they're pretty banged up. Everyone's hood smashed up and all stuff. Not a scratch on that bright orange Speed Energy truck of Robbie Gordon. So, you know, he'll methodically make his way through the pack if he can.
Keegan Kincaid, Kyle LeDuc fighting it out for position as well. This is for 6th and 7th. LeDuc in the blue Toyo tires truck, the Traxxas truck of Kincaid after each other. Let's get on board. Oh, Kyle LeDuc with a little problem there.
See, LeDuc gets it around. He goes all the way around, keeps it up on the rev limiter, smoking those Toyo tires right off. Get some heat in the tires, Rick.
I'll tell you what, I'm amazed at how durable these Toyo tires are on the Stadium Super Trucks. You can abuse the heck out of them. They seem to perform just as well. One more look at the 47 of Kincaid. There's LeDuc going around. He just gasses it and straightens it right back up.
Yep, stays right on the gas. We see one more replay of him. There's LeDuc, gets it around. You hear that thing up on the pipe, up on the rev limiter. Meanwhile, we go back to Gavin Harlan and Creed. Both of them in a full-on torque wheelie there. You see them, three wheelings, a good feeling for both of those competitors.
Creed getting by Harlan there. That was almost a full bicycle by Harlan.
It certainly was. Both hoods smashed up. Meanwhile, if I'm Gavin Harlan, I'm saying don't look in the rearview mirror. I don't want to know who's back there. You see Robbie Gordon back there in that bright orange Speed Energy Toyo Tire Traxxas truck. It would make me nervous.
Sure, absolutely. Creed, Harlan, Gordon, and Steele battling for position behind the race leader. E.J. Vizo's out in front at the moment. These drivers, though, want to have something to say about it as we work two laps to go here on the streets of Long Beach.
Just big air from Creed every single time. Creed, the young man, he's also one of those guys that's just absolutely fearless, whether he's on his dirt bike or in his race truck or whatever he's doing, and he just sends it, flat foots it off every one of these jumps.
Running order, top of your screen as always here on our coverage of the Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Again, Creed and Harlan, Gordon and Steele, second, third, fourth, and fifth in play behind the leader, Vizo. Harlan gets tapped and goes sideways off the corner.
And right, Robbie Gordon gives Harlan a small love tap, says, hey, man, I'm right here, so you better look out. You see
Harlan
a little
comes
contact.
Slamming in there, though, and makes contact with Creed's machine and goes around in turn 11. Skirmish. Steele got in.
I'd have to say, Rick, Harlan probably looked in his rear view when he got that love tap and said, oh, no.
Here's another look at it. Harlan drove in a little too deep there and has to spin it. Gordon gets by. Steele does not. The field seeing the white flag. Final lap. One more look at the turn 11 skirmish here.
And then with Harlan going around like that, that gives an opportunity for Vizo and Creed to pull out front, get a little bit of comfort there.
Robbie Gordon settling into third in front of Steele. Before the weekend began, I had a chance to sit down with Robbie Gordon and talk to him about the spectacle that is Stadium Super Truck Racing.
You know, a lot of people are just in awe of what the trucks will do. And the racing is gnarly because the wheel-to-wheel battle you can do with these trucks, any other form of proper motorsport race vehicle will be sitting on the hook, you know, one little bounce and they're done. And you'll see slide jobs, you'll see piggyback rides, you'll see all kinds of cool stuff happen this weekend.
Sean Cerberty, I get to cover a lot of different forms of motorsport. This is about the most exciting thing I have ever seen. We're having so much fun with this. EJ Vizo with a big lead on the white flag lap here over Creed and Gordon.
Great battle going on just a moment ago, but Gavin Harlan, our early leader, spun out a little bit. Now it allowed our top three to kind of spread out, take a little bit of breath. It'd be nice and mellow, try to bring it home to the checkered flag. But meanwhile, Scotty Steele, we've seen him on the podium before. He's going to apply some pressure to Robbie Gordon right now, try to get that P3 spot.
Be a nice drive for Scotty Steele, who had problems in St. Petersburg, as well as down under in Adelaide when the season began. Vizo all by himself. Second spot is Creed. Gordon slides it a little bit. His truck pretty straight in terms of bodywork. Last couple of corners here on the streets of Long Beach.
You see him coming down into that Toyo tire and Traxxas double jump right there. The checkered flag is about to come out for EJ Vizo, his second win of 2015. So congratulations to Mr. Vizo.
Caracas, Venezuela veteran has raced here in IndyCars. Among other things, his fifth career win in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Gavin Harlan comes home sixth in front of Dale Dondell, Charles Dorrance, Bill Hines, Davis, and Burt Jenner with a mechanical issue. Unfortunately for Jenner, he comes home in 12th spot after winning on Sunday at St. Petersburg back in the month of March. Gordon and Creed, they've done this dance before. Vizo 2, a little show for the fans here on the cooldown lap in Long Beach. And what about Kyle LeDuc in the 99? He's three-wheeling here. Sean, what happened to him here?
It was like Kyle, he thought he was going to get in the wall here, but no, it looks like maybe the studs just broke off, Rick. That's the first opportunity we've had to see that. That's the first time for Stadium Super Trucks. We have not seen that yet this year.
Kyle LeDuc had his problems on the weekend as well. Unable to see the finish because the right rear came off. As Robbie Gordon shows the fans how durable the sidewalls are on those Toyo tires. We'll be back to talk to our winner.
I'll tell you another thing while I'm on. I hate these dopey signs on the sideline. If you got some goofy dude holding up cards with a carrot, a candy bar, then there's a sun, and the quarterback's supposed to know, oh, screen pass.
It's actually pretty clever when you think about it.
Maybe you're right.
So what's the best tradition in college football? Take a guess.
Anybody? Anybody? I'll give you a hint. It's the playoff.
It's only the second year.
It's shiny and new like a little baby that I invented.
Oh, you invented it?
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
All right.
Did you watch last year?
Third string QB took home the trophy. Third string, that's you guys.
You don't know what's going to happen in that playoff. I can't wait.
Aren't you supposed to be working or something?
Yeah, I am.
Ice cold knock above here.
That look regulation to you? I think it needs more air.
We've streamlined shipping and improved our e-commerce with the tools on FedEx Small Business Center. It's really helped us become more efficient. Sweet. Unlike this new open floor plan. What do you mean? Well, there's no privacy anymore.
How many times a day do I apply the ointment?
Nowhere to have a meeting. And it's just...
Oh, my God!
Too loud to concentrate.
Well, good job using FedEx. At least we're all in this together, right?
Make your e-commerce more efficient with FedEx.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed. Could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Here's what I don't get. They're always whispering. It bothers me. It bothers the fans. You know what bothers the players? Always hearing pss, 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 pss.
You know, you are overblowing this whole thing. All they're doing is whispering. They're not bothering anybody.
And this is his special moment in time, a chance to add to his legacy.
Are you done yet?
What's the problem? I'm whispering.
Please.
Make the putt.
Oh, come on.
Here's something we bet you didn't know. Nearly half of all cancers can be prevented. That's right, half. Nearly 50%, mostly by making small everyday changes in your diet and controlling your weight, walking more, eating less, and eating foods that help you and your family to seriously reduce the risk of cancer. And of course, by not smoking. Visit the Cancer Prevention Together We Can website and get a free 30-day planner filled with tips, recipes, stats, and more about protecting your family. Go to prevent50.org.
The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires. We are Toyo, driven to perform.
The fans still standing here at the streets of Long Beach, Sean Sermony, they got their money's worth today.
They sure did. They were five deep at the fences all the way around, Rick.
And they watched a great drive to victory by the Venezuelan veteran E.J. Vizo. He's in victory lane with our Todd Lewis.
There's the winner's smile on the face of EJ Vizo. Congratulations. A nice victory here at Long Beach to climb and get up to the front and hang on to it.
Thank you. It was definitely very fun. And one of the restarts, I got bumped by Harlan. I really thought I was not going to make it in that corner, but I actually did. It was a pretty good race. I knew Sheldon was very fast and he was coming after me, but I needed to keep pushing so that wouldn't happen. It was a good day. I'm happy, and on to the next one.
Doesn't look like you've hardly got a mark on your truck. You were managing it pretty well all day.
Yeah, one of the first times I bring the car in such a good shape, and I'm excited. It's all about getting points for the championship, and it's good. It's all about having fun in this category.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
EJ Vizo, the former IndyCar star, winning for the second time this season. He won one of the opening rounds in Australia, comes back to win round number six here on the streets of Long Beach. Creed takes second, 5 seconds back, but he, Gordon, and Steele had a great battle.
They did have a great battle going on there, and Steele, towards the end, he had an opportunity to be up on top of the podium.
Gavin Harlan, one of the stories of the day. He's with Todd.
Gavin, a tough end result for you. You were out front for a good portion of this race, but got to be promising that you can handle these trucks this well in such a short race.
Yeah, that was just a really bittersweet race. It was so much fun, and I couldn't believe that I was out in front for almost half the race. And then after the mandatory, they started getting right up behind me. I got the lead back after I got passed, but then with one lap to go, I threw it away. I just had to hold my third place position for one more lap, but it was still so much fun out there in the lead for a long time, and then ending up fighting for a podium position at the end. And just really happy overall with the weekend.
Were you feeling a little bit of heat from the guys behind you?
Yeah, once I saw them in my rearview mirror, I kind of got a little nervous, especially Robbie Gordon, the legend, battling with him running up behind me. And that was really nerve-wracking. That might have led to me messing it up and making a mistake, but it was still a really good race for me.
Good race indeed. More success is ahead for Gavin Harlan.
Yeah, he'll be a driver to watch as the season continues, Sean Sermony. Our championship now after 6 of 20 rounds. Creed with a 9-point advantage over Gordon.
And EJ Vizo in the third position. Vizo, he wants to win the championship. He's a lot of racing ahead of us yet, Rick.
No question, not even to the halfway point of the season. Kincaid fourth in the standings. Been a great weekend here for the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas on the streets of Long Beach. Next up, Ross, a trip to the Belle Isle, Detroit area, the Detroit Grand Prix. 3 rounds of action. We'll have it for you in a couple of weeks here.
See Charles Dorrance. He had trouble earlier on Friday. Now he's in the lead, looking comfortable. Who's right behind him is Gallard as well. Both those guys not qualifying quite the way they wanted to from their lap times yesterday, but you see them moving out front early on, get a little bit of lead over the pack.
Gallard moving to the inside of Charles Dorrance to take the lead on the first lap in Sunday's event. Some three-wide racing here, and some guys having trouble.
Then you see the 56 of Pretty getting around. Pretty setting good lap times all weekend, but having a lot of bad luck. And then, as we've seen all weekend long, here is Vizo and Menge getting into each other. Vizo kind of pushing him off from the wall. Then the 454 of Brad Gallard. Full lawn dart off into the grass, Rick.
Spent a fair amount of time in the weeds, and here is that shot from on board the 454. Gallard able to stop it short of the concrete, though. Later on, lap four, coming to halfway, you've got the 74 of Sheldon Creed, the 7 of Robbie Gordon fighting it out for a second behind Keegan Kincaid, who's got some damage, but a nice lead.
Keegan looking really comfortable all weekend long. He's been very smart about it, and now he's got a little damage, but he's real mellow. He's looking to rear mirror, saw that battle unfold, and he was able to pull a good lead.
EJ Vizo with another spin there. EJ having some difficulty coming to terms with this racetrack. Meantime, final corner, last lap, Robbie Gordon tries the dive bomb, leans on his fellow competitor, the 74. Keegan Kincaid and the 47 will come home the winner. Gordon is second. Sheldon Creed loses it at the line.
And Sheldon upside down into the wall. He has always been the showstopper. Without a doubt, down in Adelaide, Australia, they absolutely ate that young man up. He loved his style.
No question about it. Sheldon Creed, a fan favorite in the Clipsal 500 weekend, the season opening weekend for the Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Here's an onboard look at what Sheldon did. Calm as you could possibly be going upside down in this thing.
You're looking really comfortable there. You didn't even see his eyes get wide as he gets in the wall, hang loose to all of his competitors and the fans.
One more look at it. Fans on their feet applauding the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck presented by Traxxas stars a great event.
Over 280,000 people all weekend long here in Adelaide, and these guys had an opportunity to really show off, and it was very, very exciting.
Australia, of course, a hotbed of motorsports with the V8 Supercars and other series. The Stadium Super Trucks will return when we return. Kincaid the winner, by the way. More from Long Beach.
I'm a sore loser.
I'm a sore loser.
Losing is not an option for me.
Be the best.
The best.
The best.
You have to have the best equipment under the hood.
That's why I
only use
Kometic products in my engines.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket, a superior quality gasket
for those of us who demand the highest level of performance.
Seen the Showtime Emmy Award-winning drama Homeland.
Hardcore jihadis right here in Germany.
Now's the time to see what everyone's talking about.
You're CIA.
I was in CIA. I'm a private citizen now.
Your name is on a kill list.
Someone is trying to kill me, and I'm just supposed to accept that? Spend my life on the run? Give up my daughter? I'm staying.
Homeland. Experience the phenomenon only on Showtime. Start your free trial now.
More than 2 million men and women have served in our military since 9/11. Now, many of them are transitioning back into civilian life. They're considering career options, writing resumes, starting businesses. ACP AdvisorNet can help. ACP AdvisorNet is a nonprofit online community where Americans can offer career advice to those who have served. Now we can serve those who served us by helping them to find their next career. Visit acpadvisornet.org.
Motorsports, endless possibilities between the start and finish line. Two wheels, four wheels, short track, long track, no track. Cars, bikes, carts, trucks. If they ride it, we got it. Off-road, on-road, rocky road. Little jumps, big jumps, bigger jumps. America, Europe, Asia, Australia. We don't discriminate, we just accelerate. Start your engines. Wednesday night, starting at 7, only on CBS Sports Network.
Maybe he's really focused.
Hey, Michael. Maybe he likes spinning the wheels.
Maybe he just loves trucks.
Maybe he's just being a boy.
Preoccupation with objects is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better.
Welcome back. We're on the streets of Long Beach for the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas, part of the Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. I'm Rick Benjamin, Sean Sermony alongside Todd Lewis with our coverage on Pit Road. This will be round six of the 2015 season as we continue to get you caught up on how we got to this point in the year. Trucks getting ready to come out on the racetrack at Long Beach. But let's go back to round number four, Sean. This was at St. Petersburg back in the month of March.
You see them starting off on the airport runway here as they get into the street circuit in just a moment as they file in the turn one. This is a long, fast straightaway, so you see them. The trick is get through turn one clean so I can be part of the rest of the race. You see him here doing that right now as Eric Davis in the Replay XD, always involved. The truck is out front. And Rick, we hop on board with the five of EJ Vizo.
Now, Vizo had kind of a challenging weekend, but he's always fast. Of course, he won one of the rounds in Australia. Here he's trying to make a move on the 48 of Scotty Steele.
You see him here going too wide right now. EJ Vizo and Keegan Kincaid off that jump. 140 miles an hour on that straightaway. But our early leader, Rick, Eric Davis, gets spun around, collects Scotty Steele. That gives EJ Vizo the opportunity to go from all the way to the back of the pack right to the lead.
Absolutely.
Lap one.
Keegan Kincaid, Sheldon Creed in the mix. You're on board with Creed. Kincaid, one of his buddies, as they go side by side behind Vizo.
He's able to make that pass stick. Now keep it in mind, Sheldon Creed starting all the way in the rear as our fast qualifier moves up through the pack pretty quickly. Knew he needed to catch EJ Vizo, who kind of made it the easy way around with that accident earlier on in the race. Drove around the outside of everyone, but now they unleash the beast on each other, Rick.
Vizo, Creed right behind him, final lap here. These two will not have an easy time of it getting to the checkered flag. Watch the action here. Vizo goes sideways. Creed gets by him. Vizo buys the wall.
And Vizo gives up two extra spots on there, Rick. He goes from the lead, dropping all the way back in the pack.
Here's another look at it. He had trouble on the right-hand side first, it turns out, before he got to the corner.
Now you see him. He goes in a little too hot, tries to line it up, but there's Sheldon Creed that just won't go away. Vizo gets over the other side of the track, and now he's swapped paint with both sides of his car, and he's dropped all the way back to fourth.
There is no margin for error on these street courses such as we have here on the streets of St. Petersburg. Checkered flag waving on round number four of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Truck season. Creed, your winner by a half a second over Keegan Kincaid. Gordon, EJ Vizo, and how about Burt Jenner looking pretty quick this weekend?
Well, that's the thing, you know, Burt's always had the speed. He's had the ability. He's just got to hold it together to the last lap, and maybe we'll see that from him here in the future.
It does turn out to be a good weekend for Burt. We'll show you more of what happened in St. Petersburg after four rounds. The championship, a tie. Creed and last year's champion, Robbie Gordon.
Now that makes a great battle, the two of those right there. But Creed, the young man, already tied up front. He was finished second last year overall. He's got a great opportunity to win this thing when it's over and done with.
All right, on Sunday, round five of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Right back here on the streets of St. Petersburg, Scotty Steele in that red 48 would take the early lead.
Starting grid lined up from the fastest lap time from Saturday for each truck. Well, you see out front, Steele, he got collected up early on in the Davis accident. He is one of the faster drivers on this series. Now he's sitting right out front. Great opportunity for him to run hard.
EJ Vizo had problems on Saturday. We go on board with him briefly. Lalo Laguna there in the 17 as he sits in the fourth, fifth position. Sheldon Creed looking back at him. They had a good battle early.
They did have a great battle. You see him almost side by side there, up to 140 miles an hour. Then you see Lalo Laguna and Keegan Kincaid in the 47 having quite a battle here as well. Meanwhile, Burt Jenner putting a lot of pressure on EJ Vizo, diving to the inside on him with his sights set on an early leader, Scotty Steele.
Steele up front, meantime, Jenner right behind, and there's Vizo, well within striking distance, but Scotty Steele, who started up front, would have a problem on this lap.
You know, it's been a long weekend for Scotty. He had a problem earlier on, getting an accident yesterday before lap one was even completed, and then you see him here on the Sunday race coast, and then looks like he spun an axle in that truck.
Under power, but not enough power. Lalo Laguna with a huge spin later in the day, then brings out a caution here coming off the final corner.
You see Lalo trying to collect himself here as he gets going down that front stretch. Not a lot of street experience from Lalo Laguna, so he did a lot of learning here at St. Petersburg.
Burt Jenner was the restart leader. We take the competition yellow halfway through. Sheldon Creed on board here. Vizo trying to drive to the inside, going into the left-hand corner.
driving to the inside of Sheldon Creed. These two battling back and forth all weekend long.
Creed and Vizo, a lot of contact here. Vizo's camera looking back at Creed, not afraid to lay the bumper to Vizo.
Nice see Rick, he's on the inside here. Meanwhile, Bert Jenner's watching this great battle unleashed behind him in the rearview mirror. A lot of pressure on Bert.
Bert Jenner trying for his first career win on Sunday at St. Petersburg. Creed and Vizo using up those front and rear bumpers on the stadium super truck.
I tell you, you see these guys, they get along great in the pits, and they don't feel like they push each other too much as you see them really leaning on one another here, but that's the way these two guys like to drive.
Eight tires sometimes work better than four in a place like this, and that's what you've got with Vizo and Creed leaning on each other. Damage, and Creed goes around, Vizo goes up and over.
And then you see them get hooked together. It's a sad finish for those two drivers, both of them fighting for a possible victory.
Tough break, a couple of the major contenders on the day, seeing their chances go away. All of this benefiting Bert Jenner, who scores his first career victory in the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. What a happy winner.
See Bert inside there. He's had opportunities to win before. He's been in the lead, but had made some mistakes. Now he's up on top of the podium. You know that feels good for Bert.
Keegan Kincaid almost 6 seconds back in second. Robbie Gordon third. Then Creed and Vizo, the rest of the top five. Lalo Laguna, despite the spin, comes home sixth. Post-race, Todd Lewis spoke to our very happy winner.
It feels amazing. You know, all these guys, they've been doing it a long time. They've been putting in a lot of races, a lot of different series and stuff. You know, I'm the rookie here. So, I'm 36 years old, but it doesn't mean I haven't wanted to be a race car driver my whole life. And, you know, sometimes that self-doubt, you wonder if you got what they got and what it takes to get on top of the box. And this proves it.
All right, let's take a look at the championship standings after five rounds out of 20 that this season we'll see. Creed goes on top by 3 points over Robbie Gordon. Kincaid right there with 121 markers. Then Vizo and Matt Mingay, the Australian, who will not run the U.S. portion of the series. Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks getting set to get at it on the streets of Long Beach. We'll come right back with our starting lineup for today's event.
I'm a sore loser.
I'm a sore loser.
Losing is not an option for me.
Be the best.
The best.
The best.
You have to have the best equipment under the hood.
That's why
I only use
Kometic products in my engines.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket.
Kometic gasket, a superior quality gasket
for those of us who demand the highest level of performance.
This is it. Game day, best day of the week. And when you play 1 week fantasy football on DraftKings, every week is another shot at victory. Every week, use your knowledge and showcase your skills. So what are you waiting for? You like football, you like winning. How about you like them both at the same time and make this week the week you get it done? This is DraftKings. Welcome to the big time.
Play 1 week fantasy football at DraftKings.com this Sunday. Play free with promo code BYWEEK.
I know a lot of complicated routines, but when it comes to keeping my skin clear, I like to keep it real simple.
So ditch breakouts the easy way with X-Out.
X-Out did all of this. It's working so good.
X-Out's the first and only one-step wash-in acne treatment.
It's like, bam.
Wow. And the Icy Cool Blast tells you it's working and feels amazing.
Like a breath mint for your face.
You'll even get our amazing body bar free. So go online and order now.
X-Out pimples, fast and simple.
Visit a Kawasaki dealer to experience ErgoFit adjustability and find your fit on the new Vulcan S.
It's the personification of pride and passion.
It's such an exciting time of the year. If you're not all in, if you just want to put your toes in the water, you've got no chance.
We're bringing you more of the game you love with Inside College Football.
If they don't get it done this year, you won't be in big trouble.
Tuesday at 9, only on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome back to Long Beach, California. Coverage of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. I'm Rick Benjamin. Sean Sermony is alongside Todd Lewis with our coverage in the pit area today. Time for our starting lineup for the season's sixth round. Bill Hines out of Nazareth, Pennsylvania. He'll be on the pole in that 57 truck. Starting second from Mesa, Arizona, young Gavin Harlan.
Also Gavin, a 2014 X Games competitor.
Wow, young gun as well. Starting third, Charles Dorrance out of Austin, Texas. And next in line in the fourth starting spot today, how about Kyle LeDuc from Beaumont, California? The LeDucs, a very well-known off-road family.
Absolutely. And LeDuc, this is his first time out in a big street circuit. A little bit of trouble in practice, but he's really picked up the pace.
Dale Dindell in the 17 will line up fifth, first time with us this year. And there's the veteran, E.J. Bizzo, in the 5 truck from Caracas, Venezuela. Going seventh today, Eric Davis from Los Angeles. That is the 75 truck, the always evolving machine. And then the 8th starter, guy who's up front every week, Keegan Kincaid.
Keegan Kincaid. You can never count him out. He's nice and mellow and very, very fast. I'm sure you're going to see him near the front of the pack.
Arizona Scotty Steele will line up 9th in the 48. Had problems in Florida. Robbie Gordon from Orange, California in the truck number 7 will start 10th today. And our final two starters starting 11th. St. Pete Sunday winner Burt Jenner from Los Angeles in the 50. And our final starter, fast qualifier, Sheldon Creed from Alpine, California, always fast in that 74.
He is always fast. But what I think is great, Burt Jenner comes off a win. Now he's the second fastest qualifier. One of the top dogs.
Our track here, just a shade under 2 miles, 11 turns. And Sean, you've watched as the Stadium Super Truck crew has placed 4 difficult jumps around here.
They certainly have. Coming out of 6 and 7, going 8. That's a downhill jump. Very high speed right there. Downhill jump. Now they really open it up as they got to back it down, going into 9. This jump, they're going to hit on an angle, going into 10, landing sideways, and then open it up all the way coming out 11 down that front stretch over those 2 main jumps.
And back to start finish. That is Shoreline Drive here in Long Beach. That kink in it makes it, it is a straightaway. You're flat out, but it makes it very, very challenging. There you see the Traxxas and the Toyo jumps back at the head of the front straightaway. Trucks are on the racetrack. Drivers are buckled in, ready to drop the green. Standing start. There's Gavin Harlan, the youngster, in that 55 truck. Now, he has been running with the series, but hasn't made his first appearance until today here in 2015. Here we go on the streets of Long Beach.
And they are off right now. Bill Hines out in front at that live truck. Live, the multi-platinum recording artist, sponsoring 3 trucks in the field. Bill Hines is one of those 3, and he is out to an early lead.
Hines over Harlan as they haul it down Shoreline. Now, the first turn here is a hard left, a 90-degree left. You've got to whoa these trucks out to, what, 140 or so miles an hour?
About 140 miles an hour, Rick, on this long straight going in here. Now, it's a pretty tight turn. First lap, not so bad. The brakes are going to start fading away on these trucks as they get later on in the race. You'll see these drivers, if we go to any in cabs, they'll be pumping the brake going into that turn, but they're still going to be flat on the skinny pedal.
They've been racing here on this circuit for more than 40 seasons. What an epic event on the West Coast. Huge opportunity for the Stadium Super Trucks to thrill the fans and put on a great show here on Sunday of Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. Hines and Harlan side by side, and Harlan gets by to take the lead.
Harlan takes it around the outside. Can he make it sick? He does. Hines was smart about it. He backed off a little bit there, said, hey, too early in the race, let's not get in a crash. If you see Harlan right now already moving out.
This is out of the turn 6-7 complex. This is what we're talking about, a downhill jump.
And it's a fast downhill, and they're going into that jump in a torque wheelie. You see the front tire up in the air, and then they're hitting that ramp like that. It's a wild section.
This is the backstretch at the Long Beach Grand Prix circuit. This is where you really gain some speed as well.
2 sections on this track, the front and the back, where these trucks are 140, just pinned out. You see them dive into 9 here, but then they got a ramp they're hitting sideways. Now look at Gavin Harlan jumping sideways into that turn. It's really the only fast way around this section.
Harlan has taken the lead. Kyle LeDuc has moved up a couple of spots as well. Here's Bizzo on the inside in that white truck, trying to elbow his way by Burt Jenner.
It almost looked like Bizzo got on the brakes a little sooner than expected there. And there you go. Jenner got right into him as we're on board here with Sheldon Creed. Really cool shot.
Those first 2 jumps coming off the final turn. Our Replay XD onboard cameras working to perfection today. Harlan, LeDuc, Bizzo, Hines, and Jenner, your top 5 as we open up lap number 2.
right now, making it look easy. Harlan out in front, feeling very comfortable. But meanwhile, you see him all packed up back here as Phil Hines gets a little sideways, almost gets in the tires.
You've got to make that hard left turn on trucks that are not built to do that at the highest speed portion of this racetrack on the streets of Long Beach. Here's another look from one of the onboard views of what happened in the final corner.
There's going in the last turn right there. Looked like Diesel got the brakes a little sooner than expected. Bert Jenner piled right into him. As I've said in past broadcasts, no love lost in between Bezo and Jenner as the two of them swap paint early on in the race.
Kincaid, Robbie Gordon, Scotty Steele all trying to work their way up from the back of the pack among the quicker qualifiers here this weekend. Dale Dondell there in the 17th giving way as they go three wide to the jump.
Now, Dondell, this is something new for him. He is a desert champion. I mean, Dondell is a bad, bad man out in the desert in the trophy truck. But to be here on the asphalt, on the street circuit, something brand new to him. But if you look at his lap times for practice and qualifying, he's a contender. He can run in the pack.
Awesome to see him out here doing battle in the stadium super trucks on the pavement, on the road course in Long Beach with the jumps mixed in as well. Running order top of your screen, as always, as we bring you coverage of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas, round number six of the season. We'll come right back to the streets of Long Beach.
Not getting enough oomph out of your energy drink? Then try an extra strength 5-hour energy shot. Its beefed up blend of vitamins, nutrients, and caffeine make it the very definition of extra strength. Plus, every great flavor has zero sugar and 4 calories. So, for an energy shot that really pulls its own weight, switch to extra strength 5-hour energy. Oh, could you go left up here? I need to pick up my dry cleaning.
Hold it down like a Snapchat. Go over your head like a snapback. Uploaded a pic, double tap that. And your flow so old, granddad.
Bruh.
It's just banter.
Yeah.
I'm way too much like a black cab.
I boss.
What you Snapchatting in the club for? Just dance, man. Like, yo, fam, a lamb. Yo, fam, yo, fam, a lamb. And yo, girl, better than. I ain't got time to be ticked off.
No.
But I got a new wristwatch.
Bang, gang, gang, gang. Bang, gang, gang, gang. Bang, gang, gang.
Technicians needed. If you're good with your hands and looking for a great career, get started here. Universal Technical Institute, UTI, gives you real-world hands-on training.
It was just a dream for me. Within 18 months, it was a reality.
It gave me a foot in the door that most people don't have.
UTI partners with the world's top manufacturers who need our professionally trained techs working in their shops.
It's the next level of technician.
They are the best of the best.
Your new career starts your first day at UTI. Call now.
Back in Long Beach, California, the streets of Long Beach, the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Alongside Sean Zermany, I'm Rick Benjamin. Don Lewis has our coverage on pit road. On the gas hard, working lap number three here today, as Bert Jenner, with some damage to that truck, trying to work his way closer to the front. Gavin Harlan still with a substantial lead.
Right now we're on board with Sheldon Prix. You see him, as you mentioned before, 140 miles an hour. That's the easy part. It's the braking, especially as the race goes on, the fluid gets hot. These guys are going to start pumping the brakes going in these turns. You see Robbie Gordon dives to the inside.
Keegan Kincaid, the veteran, young veteran, spins there but catches it.
Not something you see a lot out of Keegan Kincaid. I think Robbie, put a little pressure on him there, made him run it in a little bit farther than he wanted to. But Kincaid usually really keeps it under wraps. And you see a great battle right now in between LeDuc V Fizo and Creed. They are battling for the second position, Rick.
Coming down the back straightaway. Remember, LeDuc had a problem in practice on Saturday. Got behind a little on his steering, got into the wall. Goes sideways here as Creed dives inside.
Dives to the inside of LeDuc, but three-wheeling going at that Toyo Tires ramp, Rick, and then fast down that hill. What an exciting section of the track that is.
One of the most compelling and challenging parts of this racetrack to jump as you're going downhill. Of course, turn 11, the famous hairpin, would be one of the other difficult spots for these trucks because you've really got to slow down radically to be able to make that right-hand turn onto the front stretch. Great battle here, Vizo, Creed. You've got LeDuc right behind and Burt Jenner.
Look at Jenner's hood, all push up. That was from lap one. Before they even completed the lap there, on the last and final turn of lap one, Burt got into the back of Vizo a little bit. Now he's got to go down those long straights with his hood in his face.
Gets into LeDuc, turns LeDuc sideways a little. This is the turn 11 hairpin that's so difficult in any kind of race car. They navigate it with a little bit of body slamming going on. Harlan continuing to lead.
Now you see all the trucks getting a little sideways on this front stretch. They come out of that turn, they go over that Toyo Tires ramp. They land, they're a little out of whack, but you can't back out of the gas. You gotta stay on that skinny pedal on the right as they go off the Traxxas jump. Really sends every one of these trucks for a bit of a loop. It's a wild ride in that cab.
Sheldon Creed trying to make the crossover move on EJ Vizo here as they come to turn one. Vizo able to hold the advantage and drop to the inside and stay in front of Creed. Meantime, Jenner pushes it too hard and catches the wall and some banner.
I'd have to think, Rick, there's got to be a little bit of damage to that truck. He got into the wall pretty hard. That was a fast section to be coming around and touching the wall that way.
Now, replay, this kind of began before we got to this point. There's Vizo, Creed, and LeDuc here with Jenner going down into turn one.
And then LeDuc and Jenner really going at it back and forth. And you see him going into the wall. Yeah, that was a pretty tough hit there.
Winner of the round five event at St. Petersburg back in March, and Jenner's got that banner kind of wrapped around, it wrapped briefly around the rear wheel. Now, Burt, meantime, trying to shoulder his way by LeDuc.
Now, I would have to think right now that Burt Jenner's saying, we know we got a mandatory competition caution right around the corner. If I can just nurse the truck to that point, maybe pull over quick, get a course worker, anyone, tell me, pull this banner out, that could affect braking or anything.
Now, he did kind of side-slap the soft wall and then the concrete. These are very tough race trucks that have been put together by the Stadium Super Trucks team. Any chance there's damage on that truck?
I think that there very well could be. It's hard to say right now what's going on with the truck. He did fall off the pace a little bit right now. But like I said, maybe he's waiting for that comp caution to come right around the corner here. Well, he could kind of regroup, get that banner ripped out. Or maybe he did cause some damage. He did slap that concrete wall pretty hard.
On board with Burt Jenner, the winner at St. Petersburg in the Sunday event, it does look like he's got a problem. He's off the gas. Jenner pulling on the pit road, slowing down here. What a shame for the veteran driver, doing a great job in the early season, talking to one of the crew members. Looks like he's afraid he's got some sort of significant problem. He's pulled at the pit road, getting ready to shut it off. Meantime, the action continues as we come close to halfway in the competition yellow. Gavin Harlan there in the 55, still your leader. Vizo and Creed have caught him.
Well, I've been wondering the whole time what Vizo and Creed are thinking. Not only are they having to deal with battling each other, but they're seeing the young man Harlan out in front the whole time. First time back in Stadium Super Trucks this weekend. Here in Long Beach for Harlan, and he's been out in front of these guys the whole entire race and running extremely well.
Just gives up the lead, though, to EJ Vizo. Sheldon Creed knocking on the door as well. They do a little contact dance as they head to the jump coming off turn 6 and 7. Creed almost loses it there. Harlan right back trying to hold onto the lead over Vizo, but Vizo gets by.
Yeah, Harlan's a young kid. He's absolutely fearless, and I don't believe he's going to let a veteran like Vizo just walk away on him right now. He's going to work him over as best he can to get that lead back.
Harlan tries to dive to the inside. Vizo, though, starts to slide a little early, and obviously these drivers realize you've got to kick the back end out before you get to the corner. Kind of a dirt driving technique here.
Absolutely it is, and that's where Harlan comes from. You know, he is a dirt background, as is Creed. Vizo, he's the one that comes from 6 full years of racing IndyCar, testing Formula One. So the street course is kind of his thing, but this is two styles of driving mixed together as one. As you see him, 1, 2, and 3, Vizo, Harlan, and Creed going down those jumps. All those trucks a little bit banged up right now. Harlan, his truck was beautiful a lap ago.
All right, competition yellow falls as we begin lap number 6 of 10 today here on the streets of Long Beach. Sheldon Creed waving to the fans and maybe a fellow competitor as well. Now, the trucks will bunch back up for a restart next time around.
That's right, Rick. They'll go into their mandatory competition caution, which you'll see at every feature event at SST Racing, which means midway through the race, full course yellow, pack it up, go racing again.
Visa will be our restart leader. Meantime, Burt Jenner, who won the Sunday event at St. Petersburg in March, done for the day. He's with Todd.
Burt, I can see the disappointment on your face. Give me what happened from your seat, what it looked like out there.
Hats off to LeDuc. He, first time in a long time, he's been in the truck this weekend. But he picked up a lot of speed there at the end. I was just trying to keep up with Creed and Vizo, who are starting to kind of get away from us. And I tried for a little bit of a dive bomb, a little too aggressive. Couldn't get it stopped in time, put it in the wall. So broke a suspension part, figured pull it off before I wrecked the truck worse than it already is. And come back and get them next time.
Broken suspension parts, not something you can run these trucks with, as tough as they are. Fans loving it. The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. We're on the streets of Long Beach. Right back with the restart in just a moment.
Out for a bike ride. I didn't think I'd have a heart attack, but I did.
I'm Mike, and I'm very much alive. Now my doctor recommends a Bayer aspirin regimen to help prevent another heart attack.
Be sure to talk to your doctor before you begin an aspirin regimen.
After 10 years of providing top-notch customer service and quality products, we're still rated number one by the Wall Street Journal for do-it-yourself paint chip repairs. Our signature dab, smear, and blend process allows you to make professional, permanent repairs on your car. And now our squirt and squeegee method makes it even easier to fix the most heavily chipped vehicles. Simply squirt a little paint on the panel, squeegee it smooth over the chips, then blend as usual. Go to drcolorchip.com. That's drcolorchip.com.
Fight your enemies, conquer their cities, and expand your empire. Play now at TW2.tv. Strike back at TW2.tv.
Avocados from Mexico.
The countdown to 8 seconds is on.
Buckle up for the PBR tonight at 8 on CBS Sports Network.
Back on the streets of Long Beach, Rick Benjamin along with Sean Sermony, Todd Lewis on pit road, ready for the restart after the competition yellow. Final four laps of action as round six of the Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas unfolds today in front of a packed house of fans. Eric Davis toward the back of the field behind the three of Charles Dorrance. Bill Hines in the 57. They're going to try to move up in these last few laps, but it's Vizo who leads him over the first two jumps under the bridge into the green flag.
Well, that's the competition caution to come out of right now, which means it is a drag race to the finish line. It's a drag race to the checkered flag. We've seen young Gavin Harlan lead the majority of this race. Now he got some of these guys that have been in the trucks a little bit longer, Creed, Vizo, and they're pushing him around a little bit. Harlan's truck's a little banged up right now. It's going to be a long ride to the checkered flag.
Harlan, though, with the inside move, coming into turn one to get up alongside Vizo and retakes the lead.
You see, adding to this mess now is Robbie Gordon, that bright orange number 7-speed energy truck moved up into P4. Robbie oftentimes towards the end of the race has the best seat in the house, seeing some of these young drivers just unleash everything they've got on each other, and he scoots his way up onto the podium. I think Robbie's trying to stick to that plan right now, Rick.
Vizo and Harlan side by side down the short straightaway from the top spot here as the laps start to wind down. Green is third, Gordon is fourth. Vizo with the outside move retakes the point.
I gotta think, Rick, that Vizo and Creed are impressed, but certainly not pleasantly surprised by how fast Harlan is. He certainly has put quite a battle in here and has an opportunity to win this race yet. It's not over.
Leaders steaming down the backstretch here on the streets of Long Beach. Awesome racetrack, great facility, lots of history in the stadium. Super Trucks marking their second anniversary with this event this weekend. Scotty Steele running to the inside of LeDuc here.
Scotty Steele leaning on LeDuc a little bit there. Scotty has had several podiums in stadium Super Truck racing. LeDuc has not, but he has picked up the pace for the last 2 days of practice and qualifying, and LeDuc is really starting to move out in that 99 Toyota tire truck.
Meantime, Sheldon Creed is on the move. Up along. Oh, he loses and has to skip the ramp. What does that mean, Sean?
Well, he had to skip the ramp, so he couldn't gain any ground on anyone. So you saw him moved over, backed out of the pit gas a little bit, let Harlan get back up where he was. Otherwise, if he didn't, he would end up getting a stop and go penalty next lap around.
Robbie Gordon on the charge now on the front straightaway, watching the second and third place trucks. Vizo taking the opportunity, watching that battle in his rearview mirror to drive off to a nice advantage here.
Well, a couple great battles. Obviously, this battle for the lead is great, but look at these guys right here. This is a battle for fifth place right now. That is Steele, LeDuc, and Kincaid. Keegan Kincaid can undoubtedly be on top of the podium at any given time. And right now, he's pushing hard with three to go.
Fourth, fifth, and sixth in play here on the streets of Long Beach. Next up for the Stadium Super Trucks will be on the streets of Belle Isle, Detroit. Gavin Harlan has turned in a great run today, back in second spot. Let's get on board with Robbie Gordon in the 7 truck, the defending series champion, sitting in fourth. He can see the top three. They may be sitting ducks for Gordon.
Oh, they absolutely could. You know, he likes to pick them off one at a time. If you see the trucks up in front of them, they're pretty banged up. Everyone's hood smashed up and all stuff. Not a scratch on that bright orange speed energy truck of Robbie Gordon. So, you know, he'll methodically make his way through the pack if he can.
Keegan Kincaid, Kyle LeDuc fighting it out for position as well. This is for 6th and 7th. LeDuc in the blue Toyo tires truck, the Traxxas truck of Kincaid after each other. Let's get on board. Oh, Kyle LeDuc with a little problem there.
See, LeDuc gets it around. He goes all the way around, keeps it up on the rev limiter, smoking those Toyo tires right off. Getting some heat in the tires, Rick.
I'll tell you what, I'm amazed at how durable these Toyo tires are on the Stadium Super Trucks. You can abuse the heck out of them. They seem to perform just as well. One more look at the 47 of Kincaid. There's LeDuc going around. He just gasses it and straightens it right back up.
Yep, stays right on the gas. We see one more replay of him. There's LeDuc, gets it around. You hear that thing up on the pipe, up on the rev limiter. Meanwhile, we go back to Gavin Harlan and Creed. Both of them in a full-on torque wheelie there. You see them, three wheelings, a good feeling for both of those competitors.
Creed getting by Harlan there. That was almost a full bicycle by Harlan.
It certainly was. Both hoods smashed up. Meanwhile, if I'm Gavin Harlan, I'm saying don't look in the rearview mirror. I don't want to know who's back there. You see Robbie Gordon back there in that bright orange Speed Energy Toyo Tire Traxxas truck. It would make me nervous.
Sure, absolutely. Creed, Harlan, Gordon, and Steele battling for position behind the race leader. E.J. Vizo's out in front at the moment. These drivers, though, want to have something to say about it as we work two laps to go here on the streets of Long Beach.
Just big air from Creed every single time. Creed, the young man, he's also one of those guys that's just absolutely fearless, whether he's on his dirt bike or in his race truck or whatever he's doing, and he just sends it, flat foots it off every one of these jumps.
Running order, top of your screen, as always, here on our coverage of the Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Again, Creed and Harlan, Gordon and Steele, second, third, fourth, and fifth in play behind the leader, Vizo. Harlan gets tapped and goes sideways off the corner.
And right, Robbie Gordon gives Harlan a small love tap, says, hey, man, I'm right here, so you better look out. You see
Harlan
a little
comes
contact.
Slamming in there, though, and makes contact with Creed's machine and goes around in turn 11. Skirmish. Steele got in.
I'd have to say, Rick, Harlan probably looked in his rear view when he got that love tap and said, oh, no.
Here's another look at it. Harlan drove in a little too deep there and has to spin it. Gordon gets by. Steele does not. The field seeing the white flag. Final lap. One more look at the turn 11 skirmish here.
And then with Harlan going around like that, that gives an opportunity for Vizo and Creed to pull out front, get a little bit of comfort there.
Robbie Gordon settling into third in front of Steele. Before the weekend began, I had a chance to sit down with Robbie Gordon and talk to him about the spectacle that is Stadium Super Truck Racing.
You know, a lot of people are just in awe of what the trucks will do. And the racing is gnarly because the wheel-to-wheel battle you can do with these trucks, any other form of proper motorsport race vehicle will be sitting on the hook. You know, one little bounce and they're done. And you'll see slide jobs, you'll see piggyback rides, you'll see all kinds of cool stuff happen this weekend.
John Cerberny, I get to cover a lot of different forms of motorsport. This is about the most exciting thing I have ever seen. We're having so much fun with this. EJ Vizo with a big lead on the white flag lap here over Creed and Gordon.
Great battle going on just a moment ago, but Gavin Harlan, our early leader, spun out a little bit. Now it allowed our top three to kind of spread out, take a little bit of breath. It'd be nice and mellow, try to bring it home to the checkered flag. But meanwhile, Scotty Steele, we've seen him on the podium before. He's going to apply some pressure to Robbie Gordon right now, try to get that P3 spot.
Be a nice drive for Scotty Steele, who had problems in St. Petersburg, as well as down under in Adelaide when the season began. Vizo all by himself. Second spot is Creed. Gordon slides it a little bit. His truck pretty straight in terms of bodywork. Last couple of corners here on the streets of Long Beach.
You see him coming down into that Toyo tire and Traxxas double jump right there. The checkered flag is about to come out for EJ Vizo, his second win of 2015. So congratulations to Mr. Vizo.
Caracas, Venezuela veteran who's raced here in IndyCar.
Welcome to Long Beach, California. Coverage of the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas. Today, round six of the 2015 season, the Grand Prix of Long Beach. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rick Benjamin. Sean Cerberny alongside Todd Lewis has our coverage today down on Pitt Road. The second consecutive weekend for the Stadium Super Trucks on asphalt here at Long Beach, California. Sean, it's an awesome place to come and race, and this is kind of the birthplace of off-road racing.
Oh, it is. Being here in Southern California, not just that, but then being in Long Beach, is such a prestigious event. And now here we are, the home of off-road racing. You know, Baja right down the road, all the close course racing here. It's an absolute honor to be back here with this brand new series. And now, 3 years in a row, here we are in Long Beach. Very exciting weekend.
I know the fans love it out here.
They do. You know, it's actually one of the classes where it's so exciting that if you haven't seen it, it takes at least 3-4 laps for you to even understand what's happening out front of you. It's so wild. They're swapping paint, high-flying action, and they're right up to the fences. You know, they're 4 or 5 people deep all the way around, and it's the one race where even the IndyCar people come out of the paddock to come watch some of this high-flying action. So it's great.
The stands are filling up here on the streets of Long Beach for round six of the Stadium Super Trucks, part of the Long Beach Grand Prix weekend. These guys have been getting at it all weekend, Sean. This is Saturday practice.
So a few new guys at the pack here, Rick, which is very interesting. We had Kyle LeDuc have a little bit of trouble, a couple other drivers as well. But, of course, there is Gavin Harlan, number 55. Very exciting weekend for him.
Bill Hines with a big problem here.
Well, we were playing with the setup a little bit, so had a different setup than St. Pete where the truck was flying really well. And, you know, I came off a ramp, and then my back end got into the tires, and then it just whipped me around. So it was kind of like, you know, holding on for dear life, and then I hit the concrete wall. And, I knew it was hurt pretty bad. And, you know, I was shooken up a little bit, but, you know, I went in the hauler, took some Advil, and, you know, feeling pretty good now. So.
New face Kyle LeDuc had problems as well.
Just got up one of those super kickers on the straightaway, and I think we may have an issue with some of the suspension, but I feel like I didn't screw up, and the truck threw me pretty crooked, and I just did a quick little save, and it was able to, you know, wasn't able to catch it, and it spun me down the straightaway.
So they'll fix both of those trucks, the Hines truck and the LeDuc truck, and get them ready. Now this morning, practice and a qualifying session.
And these guys really picking up the pace now, and they know their qualifying time counts. They need the fastest lap they possibly can. Robbie Gordon's not going to use this lap. As you see, him brings it around on the front stretch, but he does keep it out of the wall, as you see the kids and everyone right up against the fences, Rick.
It is a spectacular show. The Stadium Super Trucks in action. Sheldon Creed, our fast qualifier, a 145.85 2-second lap here on the streets of Long Beach. 5 rounds of a 20-round season complete. Creed, Robbie Gordon, Kincaid, Vizo, and Matt Mingay, who will run the rest of the series. Those are your top 5 in championship points. A lot at stake here as we get set to go racing on the streets of Long Beach. More to come with the Stadium Super Trucks.
The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Traxxas. the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires. We are Toyo, driven to perform.
The truth is, you can't work from home when you're sick. You need real relief. Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Cold and Flu has three cold symptom fighters to relieve your tough symptoms. Stay unstoppable. Alka-Seltzer Plus.
The bigger, more advanced, and more capable Fiat 500X crossover with available all-wheel drive. Well-rounded has never looked so sharp. Lease a 500X for only $179 a month for 39 months and get up to 34 mpg highway.
Fight your enemies, conquer their cities, and expand your empire. Play now at tw2.tv. You got the hunger, you got the taste. You're always ready to go when the flavor is
fresh. Avocados from Mexico.
It's a full collection of expert quarterback analysis every week on NFL Monday QB, delivered by FedEx, tomorrow at 6 on CBS Sports Network.
The Speed Energy Stadium Super Trucks, presented by Traxxas. Round number 6 about to unfold on the streets of Long Beach, California, the legendary Long Beach Grand Prix Circuit. Great crowd on hand. Sean Sermony, we're getting set to see these trucks haul it down into turn one here. I can't wait to see the action at this track. Practice and qualifying, full of action. Speaking of full of action, round one of the season conducted at the Adelaide Parkland Circuit in Adelaide, Australia. The Stadium Super Trucks, a three-race weekend, part of the Clipsal 500 V8 Supercar event down there. Sean, you were there. This was a terrific show.
It absolutely was. You know, what an honor it was to be part of the V8 Supercar Series down here at the Clipsal Race. And these fans, you know, they had a special treat all weekend long. And a lot of action. You see a little highlight there of Dorrance getting to the wall. A lot of great stuff going on. And some of the Australians really adapted to these trucks quickly.
Charles Dorrance of Austin, Texas, though, on the pace lap, didn't adapt very well to the new circuit. Had a problem going around the right-hander. Upside down and into the barrier, but he's okay. The truck will survive as well. Now, the start of race one.
See, right off the bat, race one, Nathan Prix is out in front. One of the Australians comes out of the U-classes, gets right into the SSTs, starts leading the pack right off the bat.
Bill Hines, an early second-place runner. We take an onboard ride with E.J. Vizo in the 5 truck, the former IndyCar star. Vizo was a standout all weekend.
He certainly was. You know, Vizo's got quite a bit of time in these trucks. You know, he knows how to run the handbrake. He knows how to shift just properly. You see him right there making that pass to the lead, going by the Toyo Tires truck of Nathan Pretty. And next thing you know, he's just out front looking really comfortable.
Nathan Pretty, meantime, on the second lap, had a problem, a broken left front suspension piece. Not very pretty there as he fights to keep control of the 56.
Well, you see, Nathan did get into the wall, which was really upsetting for him. He said, I talked to him, I said, what happened? He said, I got out of the U-truck, got into this one, and the pedals went right, put it into the wall.
Brad Gallard there in the 454 would have his challenges ahead as well. We ride with Sheldon Creed here in the 74.
You see, Creed here gets into Gallard in that Peter Kittle truck, takes that red Traxxas truck around in front of him, but he had to run the rest of his race with his hood in his face.
Tough way to go, no question. E.J. Vizo scores the victory, the season opener, round number one, down in Adelaide, Australia. The Stadium Super Trucks presented by Traxxas, first race of the season. Vizo defeats Robbie Gordon. Matt Mingay from Australia and Keegan Kincaid, one of our hot young guns from the U.S., ends up fourth in the 47 truck. First of three races down in Adelaide, Australia. They're lined up now. Race number two came on Saturday of that weekend. We've got a great field of trucks lined up as well. Now, again, with qualifying, the inversion takes place. Fast qualifier starts at the back, but earns bonus points.
Absolutely, that's the way it is. You actually get a point off for just the weekend points, not the yearly points. So it's motocross style. Whoever has the least amount of points at the end of the weekend is the weekend's winner. So if you qualify fastest, you got to start in the back of the pack, but you're already kind of starting ahead. Right now, who isn't starting ahead? You see the 454 of Gallard gets pummeled in by the 57 of Bill Hines into the kitty litter. Not a good start of that race for them guys.
Not at all. Nathan Pretty, though, was on the button early. Had his problems in the first event. They repaired the truck, got him back out. Robbie Gordon artfully flying over the jumps here. Lap number three, we've got a battle up front. Pretty trying to hang on. And the Matt Mingay truck, the Hot Wheels truck, getting into the back end of Keegan Kincaid's machine.
Well, I'll tell you, maybe not the most gentlemanly-like way to get around that turn to Kincaid. And you see Vizo into the wall. Vizo struggled all throughout race number two.
Hard to believe because he won the open.
It was. You know, usually he's so calm and mellow. But he came out in race two, and Vizo really had a hard time. You know, and maybe it was Matt Mingay here saying, hey, brand new in the truck, and Matt was so fast that maybe that got in Vizo's head a little bit when he's trying to get around him.
Sheldon Green there, Robbie Gordon, here's Vizo again. Same spot on the racetrack.
And same guy again, Matt Mingay. So once again, you know, maybe the new Ozzy coming out here is messing with Vizo's head a little bit, but he wasn't able to put a good race together in race two.
Final lap on Saturday, race number two. Creed and Robbie Gordon to the stripe, to the checkered flag for the win. Creed beats Gordon by a truck length. Great battle between those two.
Absolutely, it was, you know, and that's something I think we're going to see all year long, but so far for our Adelaide races, you see a lot of Creed, and you see a lot of Gordon, and you see a lot of paint swapping between the two of them.
Checkered flag falls over Sheldon Creed, his first win of the season. Robbie Gordon comes home second. Matt Mingay from Australia and EJ Vizo, despite the problems, rounding out the top four. Then it was time for round three at Adelaide on Sunday.
And right now, Mingay so far with 2/3, and both Friday and Saturday, which was kind of a big surprise. First weekend out in the truck, running it hard. Now out in front.